So the purpose of this experiment is, first part of it is to separate the chlorophyll extract into its main component. The chlorophyll extract is a mixture of components, and I want to separate them using paper chromatography. I'm using more than one paper because I want as much of the separated components as possible. What I'm doing in this experiment is I am putting a drops of this chlorophyll extract into a paper made of cellulose. This is cellulose filter paper. This paper is polar. When I'm done depositing these dots of chlorophyll, I'm gonna dip this paper, I will show you how, I'm gonna dip this paper into a non-polar solvent. The paper is polar, the solvent is non-polar. The solvent is gonna be sucked up in the paper, and the different components of the chlorophyll extract are gonna go up and stuck to the paper in different points according to their polarity. The most polar ones will not like the solvent, will not dissolve in the solvent, so they will stick to the paper down there. The most non-polar components will go up with the solvent, and I will find them in the paper up here or up there. We will see the separation toward the end. Now, one drop of the chlorophyll extract is not enough. I need to put different drops, but I need to wait until the chlorophyll is totally dry, and then I put another point, and then totally dry, and then I put another point. Usually the way we do it is we put one point, one drop, and then we leave the papers for 3 minutes, and then we put the other drop. So we will wait for these to dry, and then we will add another one. So we are waiting for the spots to dry, and then we are adding more of the chlorophyll extract. This is the spot number 4. I will show you at the papers. I'm waiting for 3 minutes between one spot and another until it dries. We will add until the seven spots, and then we will transfer the papers to the chromatography chamber. So this is the acetone and petroleum ether. That's enough. And this is the third paper. Now, as you can see, the solvent is traveling. I'm working under the hood because the petroleum ether is volatile and acetone is volatile. They should not be allowed to evaporate inside the room. We will leave them to migrate, and then we will see the separation of the different pigments of the chlorophyll extract. These are my papers after separation of their main pigments. What we have obtained is 4 different colors. This is chlorophyll B, olive green. This is chlorophyll A, bluish green. And this is the xanthophyll, yellow in color. And this is the carotene, which is orange in color. The most polar is the chlorophyll B. It remains all the way down. The most non-polar is the carotene, which travels all the way up with the solvent.